Hey guys, so today we're going to be showing you projector LEDs, also known as shadow lights. To start off, let's open up the box. Inside is pretty simple, comes with two lights inside, and a hole saw. So I'm going to show you guys how these activate. It's really simple, it just needs 12 volts. On a typical installation, it's hooked up to the dome light circuit. So it's either going to be typically either negative trip or positive trip. So I'm going to just quickly show you what that's going to look like. So in a positive trip situation, the black bar is just going to be on ground, and that'll be constantly ground all the time. And then when the door opens, it may show, it's going to show positive. So laying on ground right now, I'll just turn off that sound for now so you guys can hear me better. And then when I feed it positive, you can see this go red. That turns on the light. Now let's say you had a negative trip dome light. So what's going to happen is this wire is always hot. It's always 12 volts. So to activate it, it's going to need to see ground. So when the door opens, it goes ground. So it's pretty simple. Okay, let's talk about how you're going to mount this. I'm just going to use a thin piece of MDF as an example. Now, what you saw in the box really came with a hole saw. You can use pretty much anything to make a clean hole. I like to use the step-up bit or a cone bit. And we just have to make this diameter. So, what you can see here is these little rings come off. They're just threaded on. Take that off. And you need to make this diameter in the material. Now you don't have to worry about too much about mounting depth because it goes pretty flush with the panel. But you want to double check if you're going to the bottom of the door, just double check to make sure that it's not rubbing because it's going to rub on this afterwards. I'm going to go ahead and use a step up bit. I've already made my pilot hole. Now if you don't know, that's the nice thing about this, is it's the correct diameter. But if you're using a cone bit and you don't know how big it's supposed to be, double check. Don't just go blasting a hole through. This isn't big enough, you see. But it's easier to take away material. You can never add back in material. So we're going to take our time and keep going and double checking it. So, not quite there. Back on the other side. Now that the hole's made, you can go ahead and fit the light in. Now to secure the light, you can either glue it or use the rings that you took off. I would suggest putting the ring on because now you make it serviceable. If you glue it, you might have trouble later on if you have to service this for some reason. So put that ring on. Now you saw me took off another ring, but the material is just too thick so it won't fit on. But if it's really thin material and you have enough threads, go ahead and put on that second ring because it'll act like a jamming nut. If you can't, I just put some hot glue or some sort of adhesive on the corners, not the whole way around. That way if you have to service it, you can break it off, but it'll help stop it from rotating ever. Okay, let's see this thing work.